Hello student, welcome back to social class. Last class we were in the lesson that is union government. There we already completed about the two houses of parliament, as upper house and as lower house. As a Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha we completed, and even though we move towards the next one, there is a powers and functions of parliament. I'll start from here only. Powers and functions of a parliament. Then we already completed about how it can be a formal law, yes or no? Or how it can it will be a primer law we learned in our last class. About which we learned about the as the organs of the constitution, it is very important to you. As we were taking here as a nearly three organs along with the other part as we are learning in our powers and functions of a parliament. Among that the first one, that is the legislative power. Now let's learn power. And also we can consider it as it is a executive power also. Clearly. So here in the parliamentary system of government, India was following there as a parliamentary system of government. Yes or no? Here who will be consider, who will be look after this executive power means it is the Prime Minister and it is the Council of Ministers. Council of Ministers. So in the parliamentary system of government, as a prime minister and also minister or council of minister, they will be formed as about the executive power here. As about the member of the parliament, member of the parliament, they can be asked a question to a council of minister. They can be asked a question to a council of minister, but it should be given an answer. Here, who has to be given your answer? It is none other than Council of Minister. So, member of the parliament, they can ask a question regarding any point and it should be answered by the Council of Minister. And as a Council of Minister, till where they can be in the government, till where they can be keep their as a trust in the parliament. Parliament having their as a trust in the Council of Minister till there, they can be in the power also. The members of the parliament, they can be asked a question to a council of ministers and it should be answered by them. It must. They have to because they want their suggestion. Now they have to be given their suggestion or a solution while giving an answer to their questions here. And even though as a council of minister, they will be in the power. Till where they can be in the power is till where they can keep their trust in the parliament. And even though as a parliament, it will be under the control of power here. I hope you are understanding about the administrative or executive power. Now let's go towards the third word, that is the financial power. Financial power. Lok Sabha, it will be exercised under the control of entire financial matter of the country. Almost all financial matter of the country will be allowed. It is under the control of Lok Sabha financial matter. So Lok Sabha, it was exercised under the control of entire country. So here we already learned as a financial bill, it was or it should be first presented in a Lok Sabha only. And even though as a government, in order to levy a tax or in order to spend the money for any other purposes, first they should take a permission of Lok Sabha. Even as the government also given a permission or given a work to a Lok Sabha, but as about the financial matter, it should or must take a permission with the Lok Sabha in order to levy a tax or in order to spend the money for any other development part. As a government also, it should be taken a permission of a Lok Sabha here. After passing a bill from a Lok Sabha, it will be go to a bill, it will be put towards or it will be transferred to a Rajya Sabha. So here you can consider legislative unit, which is a direct running team. They are important for where it should be present in either house, either upper or what a lower house. Both house also they have to be present here. And also even the approval of the bill, it should be done or it is needed by the approval of both the house of parliament. It is needed for this amendment. So approval also of both the house of parliament is needed for amendment. Is needed for amendment. I told you that anything it can be present in a both or either house, it is required. It must. And even to have a good approval means a permission from both the house of parliament as it is needed here. If it is one house approved and the house is not, then it cannot be carried out, we can consider here. So I hope you are understanding both the house of parliament's approval is must here. So I hope you are understanding. In some situation or in some other situation, what will be happen here means the approval of a state assembly also is essential here. So both the house of parliament also it is important, and also even in the state assembly also it is an essential part we can consider for some other situation here. So I hope you are understanding the amount of power to amend the constitution. There also both the house of parliament is must here in order to present the bill, in order to approve the bill, in order to pass it the bill also we can consider here. So this is the amount of power to amend the constitution. And even though we learn about the five power, still more other powers are there. Other powers of parliament. Other powers. What are the other powers are there? Nearly five are the children. Now let's learn one by one. First of all, in order to frame law, it is mainly related to a power and jurisdiction of Supreme Court and High Court. To frame law, it is mainly related to power and jurisdiction of both Supreme Court and High Court. That is the first one. And the second one is there to establish one High Court in a two or more states. To establish one High Court in boundaries of the state. And next one is in order to discuss the matter or to report of emergency. To discuss report of committees that is the Public Service Commission, Finance Commission, Election Commission, and also Backward Caste Commission. So nearly a four commission it will be there. And also in order to approve, in order to approve, what approval of here is? Approval of declaration of emergency. Declaration of emergencies. They are national emergencies. State emergencies. And also financial emergencies. So let me learn now one by one about the other powers of a parliament. Even though it is having the legislative power, executive or administrative power, financial power, and about the state amendment power, and about the judicial and other about the judicial power we learned, along with the other powers also will be having a parliament. What are the theories? That is the must clear. That is also even in that part also it is important as a parliament here. In order to frame a law, it is mainly related to power and jurisdictions of a Supreme Court and High Court here. Next one is to establish. In order to establish one High Court for two or more states, we are not having that as each state it was having its own High Court. Somewhere they are having that as a two or three states it was having only one High Court. In order to establish that also as a power of the parliament is first here. Next one is to create a new state. In order to create, in order to bring there as a new state, and it should be given there as a new name or put the rename. Names will be there as per earlier one, and another one name will be given there as well as for the parliament power is must here. And then determine the boundaries of the state, and it should be required that as a about the boundary of a state also, it is required for that purpose also. Power of parliament is must be here. Next one is to disclose the report of a committee. In order to report a committee regarding a public service commission, regarding a financial commission, regarding an election commission, and regarding a backward class commission. So there also as a report of a committee, in order to discuss a matter regarding the report of a committee also, as a power of a parliament is must here. Next one is there is a approval of declaration of emergencies. Whenever as an emergency is came, even in a national part or about a state part or about a financial part, and there also as about the power of the parliament is must here. Till now we learned about the one organ of a union government, that is the union legislature. We learned it is none other than it is a parliament. As about the parliament, it was a consist of two houses, upper house and lower house. It will be together, we can call it as it is a house of a parliament. We learned this. So I hope you are understanding about the parliament or about the union legislation matter. So now next we will go for the next organ of the government. It is none other than executive, and it will be there in the union government, means union executive we are learning now. We already completed there as one organ, that is the union legislature, that is a parliament pillar. Now, union executive. Union executive. And also given as about the executive matter. The executive, it was implemented the law, it was framed by a union legislature. The executive, it implemented Now we'll go for the second one, that is the administrative matter. And administration, how it will be run is, first it is required as the lawyers or no. So it will be already it was implemented or it was framed by the union legislature here. And it is also implemented as the union government's policies and the programs also. It is also implemented union government policies. Now policy it was already framed and it will be go for one by as a vote of bill, it will be passed like that only it will be go whenever as a call it was got it from that of president, then only it will be become as a law bill. Now policy program already brought here, now it should be administered. So second step we are forming. So that's what law, it is already framed. President, Prime Minister, and his Council of Ministers. Council of Ministers. Then we learned in the Union Legislature, it also consists of Upper House and Lower House, we learned. And here it also consists of President, Prime Minister, and other Council of Ministers. President, the article 52 of our constitution, it was created as a part of post of a president. Article 52 of our constitution, it created the post of president. Head of the
You are learning in the next class. Till then, take care. Thanks.